Hi, thank you for joining Pioneer. My name is Aaron Pence. I'm from the Norman Central Library. I appreciate you spending a few minutes with me today. In this video, we're going to go through actually getting started using Scratch. We're going to start manipulating what are called sprites. They're the essence of a computer program in Scratch. So the first thing that you need to do is you need to go to Scratch and you need to get logged into your account, or you need to start creating something. Remember, the address is scratch.mit.edu. In the last video, I made an account. I hope you did too. Whether or not you did, you can always click create or use the downloaded offline editor if those are the tools that you chose to use. But I'm going to sign in to my account, which is Mr. Pence, right here. And then it's going to take me to this screen. The only other thing I need to do is in the top left, I need to click create. When I click create, it's going to take me into the Scratch online editor where I can create my own projects. There are a lot of beautiful things you can do with Scratch. When you first look at it, it's just sort of a blank canvas, but I want you to think about it just like you would a sandbox. A sandbox is just a pile of dirt. Just like Scratch is a bunch of white screens sitting right here in front of you. But it's also an endless set of possibilities. There's a lot of things you can make, do, create, imagine, destroy, whatever, in this tool. It's super, super versatile, and it's super, super cool. What we're going to do today is talk a little bit about the window, what you're looking at here, as well as how you start to make things in here. On the left, over here on the side, you've got all of these different programming blocks. You will hear me call these a bunch of different things, but the word I'll most commonly use is blocks. Sometimes I'll call them functions. Sometimes I'll call them scripts or pieces of a script. But really, I'm going to try to call them blocks as much as I possibly can. Over here on the right, this big blank set of dots, you can probably see they're tiny, tiny, tiny little gray dots on your computer. This big old blank set of dots, this is your canvas, but this is really your script editor. This is where you're going to build your actual computer program. Over here on the right, where you can currently see an orange cat, and yes, you can click and drag the little cat around. This is where you can actually see the Scratch program that you are making using the script editor over here on the left. This is where the program will happen. Down below that, over here on the bottom right, I'm going to scroll down a little bit so you can see the rest of it. You'll see a couple other areas. One is your sprites area. The other is your stage area. We'll talk about the stage in a later video. You can make cool backgrounds. But the sprites area allows you to control the characters in your game. We've been moving around this cat up here. This cat is a sprite. She's a character that starts out, every Scratch program you ever make starts out with that one little cat there. And whenever you use Scratch, you're going to be making all sorts of sprites. Sometimes they're little characters like a cat, like a watermelon, like an airplane. Sometimes they're invisible characters that do seemingly magical things. Today, we're going to be making letters. Sometimes they're buildings or clouds. A sprite is anything that does stuff in your video or your game or your story that you make inside Scratch. Sprites are very easy to get started using. There's two things I want you to know today. One is how to add sprites and one is how to remove them. We're going to go backwards. We're going to remove them first. If you look in the bottom right corner, you see the blue part where the sprite one is highlighted. There's a trash can sitting up on the top right corner, right above her head. If you click the trash can, she will disappear. You've put her away. You've put her back in the sprites library. You can add sprites down here in the bottom right. There's a menu. It's a little cat head with a plus sign, and when you poke it, you can see a menu pop out of it. Kind of fun. If you unpoke it, the menu goes away, and if you poke it again, the menu comes back, and if you unpoke it, the menu goes away, and if you poke it again, the menu comes back, and so on and so forth. This button that you're poking is the Add a Sprite menu, and it gives you four different options for creating a new sprite in your game. The first one is actually the same as if you just click the cat head with the plus sign. The cat head with the plus sign and the magnifying glass are exactly the same button. Those are the Choose a Sprite button. It allows you to pick a sprite out of Scratch's library of sprites. You'll see a bunch of stuff in there. We'll go there in just a minute. But you'll see stuff like a cat, or a watermelon, or an airplane. The second button is really fun. It might be the best one of all. It's the paint button. You can create your own sprites from Scratch. You can paint them yourself. It's super fun. We won't get to it today. But I encourage you, please, go spend some time, play with it. It's really fun. You can make your own sprites from nothing at all, just from your imagination. The next button here is surprise. What that means is, Scratch, would you please just pick a random sprite for me? It can be kind of fun. I won't use it today, but you're welcome to click it if you enjoy surprises. And then the last one, the top button, where it says upload sprite. Again, this isn't something we're going to mess with today, but it's really neat. You can take a picture from your computer, or you can put a picture on somebody's phone and then upload it. You can use files on your computer as part of Scratch. So if you've already made some beautiful artwork, or if you have a funny baby picture of you you want to use, or something like that, that's a great way to get it done. I'm going to come back to the bottom part of the menu, and I'm going to click on the Choose a Sprite button. Remember, that's the cat head with the plus sign or the magnifying glass. And it takes me to this menu right here. This is all the sprites that Scratch comes loaded with. There's a lot. If I start scrolling down, my computer can't even keep up with how many they are. There's so many of them. There's lots of stuff for you to choose from. And all you have to do is find one you like. Like here, I like this ballerina. If I point at her and click, she comes back to my Scratch game right here. There she is. Super cool. And I can move her around just like the cat, get her positioned just where I want her, just like we had before. I now have a new sprite called Ballerina. I can click on the head again and grab something else. Like, let's say I need some bananas for my ballerina. Well, there we go. I have a set of bananas for my ballerina. She can munch on them or dance with them or take them to a baseball game. I can also remember, get rid of my sprites. That's what I'm going to do in this case. I don't want either of these sprites. What I'm actually going to do is I'm going to write the word hello. So I need to get rid of these two sprites. Remember, all I have to do is click on the sprite I want to get rid of down in the sprite selection menu. And then click the little trash can in the top right corner. Now, what you're going to watch is me do the same thing 5 times. I'm going to get in the sprite selection menu. I'm going to go to a category. The category is letters. I'm going to pick out the letter I want, and then I'm going to position it on my screen. I want my screen to say hello when I'm done. I'm going to talk while I'm doing it so you can see just how it works. But I'm going to come down to choose a sprite, click the button. Now, the letters are all the way at the bottom. If I start scrolling, I have to scroll. And I am old, and that sounds hard. So what I'm going to do instead is I'm going to use the categories up at the top part of the screen. You can see all, animals, people, etc. I'm going to click on letters, and there's a whole bunch of letters. I didn't even have to scroll. Thank goodness. Now, I'm going to click on each letter that I want. In this case, I want an H. So I click on the H, and there's an H right there on my screen. And then I'll position it just where I want it inside my editor window. I'm going to come back to the Add a Sprite menu. I'm going to click Letters. I'm going to click the E. There's my E. And I'm going to position it accordingly. And I'm going to keep doing this until I've got all the letters that I need. I need 2 L's to go next to my E. And then after that, I'm going to come back to Letters, and I'm going to find me an O. And after I've found my O, I have finished making my word hello. Click on O, I need to position it, and there we go. I now have the word hello sitting right on my screen. Perfect. So your job today is make a word in Scratch, add some sprites, and remove them. After you've done that, the next video will show you how to start making them move, how to actually start building your own program. Thanks a lot. See you then.